Chu, and I'm one of the costume supervisors on EastEnders. Daily basis would be checking continuity, making sure the dresses are all okay, and creating the looks from the stock of clothes that we have for the characters in my blocks. I did my A-levels and did art and history of art and costume. Then I did a foundation at the Wimbledon School of Art and then a 3-year degree. And after that, I went to work for Channel 5 on the now defunct Family Affairs. And my friend Ruth was working here, needed someone to cover her for 3 days. 3 days turned into 3 weeks of doing the junior runner sort of role within the costume department, which is mainly washing, ironing, and being kind of like the person on hand to run between studios. A job came up being the design assistant for the series designer, and I thought, why not? I've only been here 3 weeks, but if you don't ask, you don't get. I applied for it and I luckily got it, and I was design assistant for 4 years, and then I was moved up to be supervisor. The BBC wasn't how I thought it was going to be. I imagined it to be very stuffy and an institutionalised, scary sort of organisation. It actually was very welcoming and a nice place to be. I think that they're a progressive organisation who want new people, new ideas and a new perspective, as can be seen with our online work with E20, bringing in new writers, new designers, new supervisors to put something out there that's never been done before. I studied costume making, so historical costume making, which although not relevant to EastEnders, is relevant to other work that I do. But the skills I learned on that course are transferable to EastEnders for the dressmaking. We do a lot of weddings. We have a lot of weddings and a lot of christenings and a lot of deaths. And all of those skills of dressmaking come into play with things like that. Even on the day-to-day basis, you have fittings with actresses and actors, and you need to be able to do that professionally and properly, and learning skills, sewing skills on my degree course has been invaluable. I think the character traits you need to work in the industry and in the BBC, you need to be confident in what you're saying and your ideas. I think you need to be a team player because you're working with so many people. Everybody has got their own agenda and schedule they're working to. But at the end of the day, you're all part of one big production. So being a team player and being organised is incredibly important. And I just think being a pleasant person, a smile will get you a lot further than a scowl. I think the BBC's training opportunities are excellent for its staff. I recently did a HD training course for learning about how costumes look on camera now that we're filming in HD, and I think now we've gone over to HD, I would have been very nervous about filming had I not had the experience of that course and known about how it changes fabrics and the filming process and how it works with transferring it to the screen and all those kind of things. I would have been sort of lost really without the training, and I don't think that if I'd been working for any other production company, I would have progressed quite so quickly as I have in the BBC, because they like to move people up. They like to see you grow. It might sound a little cliche, but I think the benefits of working for the BBC are that we are a big family, and you spend 12 to 14 hours a day at work, and it's a nice place to be. You're going to be here for sort of that length of time. It's nice that we all really get on and they really support their staff.